I'd like to welcome to the program, Lazlow.
Is this Big Kev's geek stuff?
No, please don't.
What happened to that guy? He's dead, isn't he?
No, Kev's not dead.
How come he's not on this channel anymore? Same reason all of us aren't on this channel
You would
anymore?
Have to ask Tim Sabian that answer.
Oh,
but Tim
shizzle.
Sabian's not on this channel anymore either.
This place is just... People are just... This is like a zombie apocalypse movie, this whole place. It's just slowly shedding everyone.
Right. A lot of turnover.
A lot of turnover. One of the hosts gone.
Yeah, the namesake of the channel is gone. And we had to retool and wonder if we were still employed.
Yeah, it's a good look.
Yeah.
But hey, you know, that's the entertainment industry. Nobody said it was going to be stable.
Or fun. Yeah. Well, Lazlow's here. I've known Lazlow for many, many years. I think at some point, we were trying to figure this out. At one point or another, we may or may not have crossed paths at WLIR on Long Island.
Yeah, it's true.
Right.
I worked there for a while.
And then you've been associated with this show, geez, 10 years.
Yeah, since it came onto satellite.
Right.
Yeah, exactly 10 years.
You did part of your show before coming over to XM. You did it over at K-Rock when K-Rock was still around in New York City.
And K-Rock was still doing talk.
And one of the coolest moments I had on your show was being there the Sunday after Howard ended his run at CBS, and we got to look at see how them just gutting the studio.
They were tearing it apart.
Right, and stuff was laying in the hallway, and some of it may or may not have ended up at my house.
Yeah, you were looting.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a weird scene, the whole thing. And then they'd offered us a full-time show. It was going to be late nights from like 11 p.m. till 3 in the morning.
Right.
And, you know, of course, for shit money.
Is that John Minnelli?
I think it was one of those folks. I said, you know, my sidekick can actually make that amount of money or more as a carpenter.
Right.
So until you start offering some real money, then I wasn't going to have him quit his job. And I'm glad, because then all this next thing you know, it's some pop nonsense.
Right. But going through the hallways in there and taking a lot of things and what have you, there were engineers at K-Rock that were throwing out his Las Vegas set downstairs in the dumpster. One of the guys went down there and took the big Vegas sign. I saw him walking out just down the sidewalk and went to the parking garage and shoved it into his car.
It's really weird how, you know, you have a legacy show like that and then it's just gutted. And but that's the way of radio.
Right.
Somebody leaves and it's like all this amazing stuff just gets looted and tossed out the window.
I think some of it was supposed to make it over to Sirius, but we see that didn't happen. Lazlow also works at Rockstar Games, which everybody who listens to this channel knows, and knows his history with the Opie and Anthony show, and knows his history with Grand Theft Auto.
That's a video game shirt you're wearing, isn't it? It's a BioShock.
That it is, Rapture.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of that series. Did you like Infinity?
I loved them all.
Right.
Video games are... I don't have a lot of bad words to say about games, because games are so much fun to me. I don't even... People said, do you watch that TV show? No. Have you seen that movie? No. Because all I want to do, I don't have enough hours in the day
right.
to play the games, you know, that I want. And, you know, when I go home at night, I don't turn on television. I don't even have cable. I literally just fire up the Xbox One or the PlayStation 4
and just play games. How is that an escape when you're working on stuff that for video games to go home and then play video games?
It's weird. Everybody at Rockstar seems to do that. You know, you've got a controller in your hand a lot of the day and then you go home and play games. But the thing about it is you experience games in a different way. So, you know, when over the last few months, we'd added all this new content to GTA 5 because we have all this additional things that we can do with graphics and audio and so forth with the next-gen consoles. And so, you know, you've got a developer build and you're flying through the world and dropping your character and then testing out functionality and testing out audio and all that. It's very different than going home and, you know, playing a game that another company made
right.
and getting immersed into that.
What do you play when you're not doing Rockstar stuff?
A lot of Vita. I've been playing a lot of Vita lately because I've been on the road.
Okay.
I love a PlayStation Vita.
Doing Minecraft?
You know, I have... you know what? I'm afraid I'll come across as a pedophile.
Yeah.
Because everybody I know, their kids play Minecraft. So I'm a bit concerned about going there. But no, I mean, you know, with the Vita now, you can do shooters properly because you've
right.
got the two sticks.
You can also transfer your games to and from the PS4
yeah.
to your Vita.
And also, if your chick is watching television... and it's the TV that the PlayStation 4 is hooked up to, you can literally just stream the game from the PlayStation 4 to your Vita, and you can be in the other room you know, playing Grand Theft Auto 5
and ignoring your chick.
And ignoring your chick.
Right.
But because before there was lots of fights over, hey, you know, I wanted to play games. And she's like, I want to watch some shitty show. But now you can just turn the PlayStation 4 on. It connects to the Vita. And then you're playing the game on the handheld device.
Does it bother you when some people think, when they see all the promotion for GTA 5 on TV and whatnot, like, oh, finally it's out, and not realizing it was out a year ago on the PS3 and the Xbox 360.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know how they missed that.
I don't know either.
It was the biggest thing I've ever been involved
in.
Right,
but like everyone, some people do think that this is the grand launch of the new GTA series.
We have, you know, released a lot of promotional videos and trailers and stuff lately, right. And the commercials are all over TV. Because, you know, work didn't stop when we shipped GTA 5 on the previous consoles. We were still making content because we, you know, you have a ton of people own 360s and PS3s, but we knew that there was some really exciting stuff that we could do with the next-gen consoles that we couldn't do with the previous gen, so work never stopped. I mean, you know, we didn't stop and have, like, celebration launch parties or whatever last year. We went straight into polishing and working on, you know, first person mode and all these other things that are new to the series.
On the Rockstar website, you have side by side comparison videos of how everything looked on PS3 and Xbox 360 compared to Xbox One and PS4 now. With the new updates for the new generation systems, is there anything maybe a little special in the PlayStation version than the Xbox One version, or are they both equal?
No, they're both pretty much equal. It's just a matter of which online system you prefer, Xbox Live or the PlayStation Network, and both of them have their benefits. I kind of used to go one way or the other, and then when consoles came out, I just bit the bullet and just bought both. Because there's games that come out on the PlayStation 4 that aren't on the Xbox One, and I'm like, oh, I really want to play that
game. I've seen that a lot, because I'm in that kind of quagmire where I don't know which system to get right now, and I put it off a year, and now it's at the point where I have to now get something, because if I want to keep playing Xbox 360 and PS3, you're just not going to do it anymore because those game lines are drying up. I've seen so many people nowadays with these two systems buying both, and they're at the most expensive that gaming systems have ever been. And that's just so unusual that it's like, look, screw it. I'm just going to have to buy both because of, I think PS4's got more RPG stuff and Xbox got more first-person shooter style stuff.
Yeah, I think that could be true. The thing, though, is when I turned off my cable, I was spending a fortune on cable.
Right.
When I turned that off, to me, it freed up $140 a month for other entertainment. And so, you know, if I want to watch TV shows, I've got Netflix through my PlayStation or my Xbox, or, you know, my smart TV came with it. And, you know, people freak out, oh my God, a console is $400. But it's like you spend $150 a month on, you know, iTunes and cable and all this other kind of stuff that, you know, when you spread it out over a year, it's not that crazy to buy two consoles.
Right.
And also, you don't get that whole regret of like, oh, I really would love to play that game, but I can't, because, you know, the console developers will do exclusives to try to get you to buy their console.
Yeah, that was another thing I wanted to ask you about. Were you guys approached to have some kind of exclusive deal? Because Destiny that came out not too long ago, Sony and PlayStation had this thing where they bought even into advertising exclusivity, where they could advertise the game, but Xbox couldn't advertise the game for Xbox. They had to go and do some, you know, workarounds, but they couldn't just have a commercial saying, we have Destiny for the Xbox. I mean, it's gotten that far now.
Well, yeah. I mean, it used to be, you know, GTA was PlayStation only for quite a while. And then, you know, the Xbox came along.
Because 3 was the one that went through the roof as far as mainstream goes.
Right.
And that was PlayStation only.
That was PlayStation only. And then, you know, when the Xbox came around and we released GTA 4 in 2008 on both the Xbox and the PlayStation. And so, you know, now those two companies are fiercely competing against each other. So they'll do a deal with a video game manufacturer and say, you know, we want to be the logo that is associated with, you know, your title. So it's all marketing stuff. I don't get involved in that. It hurts my head.
Are you still catering to PC gaming or no?
Well, GTA 5 is coming out on PC in January.
Okay.
So, you know,
is it going to get the big push like the platforms
the
are
PC,
getting here?
Market has been wanting it for a long time, and again, we're polishing stuff on that that's not in the consoles.
So each time a new version comes out, there's more stuff than, you know,
there's
than
just,
the previous
there's a lot
version.
There's a lot more that you can do. And, you know, we love the PC community because they go in and do cool mods and you know, it's like having an active partner that can show you some amazing things that are possible in your game. In fact, there was one guy who shot a movie in GTA 4 and it was so well done and the cinematography was so great that we hired him to come work on our trailers. So,
that's so weird.
So, you know, we pay a lot of attention to the PC community and the things that, that they're doing. And, you know, I don't even, to me, the word machinima just cheapens what is some really cool stuff that people are doing. You know, it's not just people sort of wiggling back and forth and doing some voiceover. People make some amazing stuff in the PC games.
You're saying a lot of new stuff each time the game comes out, but the radio channels, there's a lot more content as far as the radio channels go. Are you still doing a show on the radio channels?
The game that shipped last year, I do have a show in that one. With a female sidekick that I fight with constantly.
Was this on that on the talk station?
It was on the talk station.
The West Coast
yeah.
Talk Radio?
And so now we've added a lot more talk radio with Danny McBride has a show on there. He plays a character called Dwayne Earl in a Beyond Insemination is the name of that show. Chakra Attack is a show that's hosted by JB Smoove, who was fantastic to work with. So, you know, the other thing is, we knew that we wanted to create all this content, but the Xbox 360, PlayStation 3 version, there's just not enough room.
Right.
That's why, you know, when you've got all this additional disk space, an additional horsepower of these new gaming consoles, it's like you can make the water look incredible and just have the graphics be so stunning.
Yeah, the water does look incredible. I love the all the excess you've put into the games. The country club looks amazing. The tennis courts looks awesome. Yeah. And the skydiving is awesome, too.
Nice.
From the clips I've seen where the skydiving, you see the mountain range and the sunset and everything. It's just, I don't know how much further you can go that you need to develop to keep it look, that doesn't look real.
You know, it's amazing. When we released Vice City, I was like, this game looks amazing. It's so beautiful. And San Andreas added even more. And with each new title, you know, you go back to those previous titles where you're like, I don't know if it can ever look any better than this.
Right.
And then it does.
I found my old, I forgot what it was called now, the old original PlayStation handheld for Vice City Stories.
Oh, with, yeah, with the PSP.
This little circular disc and the white cartridge and everything. Yeah. I was playing that for a little while. And it's just like, it has come so far.
Yeah. But, you know, the thing about that is like, I mean, look at a game like Minecraft or a game, you know, like GTA 3, Vice City Stories, that, you know, the graphics are interesting and good, but it has to have amazing gameplay.
Right.
And that's what gets people into it. So, you know, there's games that have fantastic graphics, but if the gameplay
sucks,
is not there, or it's
Titanfall
not,
is one of
it's
them.
It's not engaging. I played a lot of Titanfall.
It looked great. I don't like the fact that I'm not a huge first-person shooter game, but I don't like the fact that I couldn't just do it by myself, but it was always online. And that kind of throws me off a little bit because I just don't want to play with assholes half the time. You just like, I want to go in and experience it for myself, but no, you can't. You're online.
That's why you got to play with friends from work. That's what I do.
You were talking about the gameplay. What's the runtime for playing the game if you don't do all the extra stuff? If you're doing just the story, like, how long is this going to take you about?
60 hours?
That's not too bad.
I haven't heard what the total is. There's so many things to get distracted with and enjoy that it's like,
I never complete, like in 4, I think I got halfway through it, but I was just having too much fun stealing the helicopter and just flying into the city and doing all these other little things rather than actually playing the story.
Yeah, everybody plays Grand Theft Auto in a different way.
Right.
But the story in this one is really well done. It's worth taking it to the end because you got to make some interesting decisions.
Any updates with the social club involving this game?
Oh, dude, we are doing so many social club events. If you go to the Rockstar Games website, I mean, we give away a ton of stuff to social club members, and we do a lot of live broadcasts. I think we're talking about having you guys come by, and so your fans
can awesome.
Decimate you in GTA Online. So, yeah, we have people stop by all the time. Celebrities and guys that helped us with the soundtrack and the score will come by and play. And that whole world of Twitch and the YouTubers out there, I mean, there's YouTubers that we play with that have got, you know, 7.5 million subscribers. And there's more people watching some guys play on YouTube live than there are people watching some network TV shows. I mean,
yeah, it's ridiculous.
It's ridiculous.
Do you sit there and watch Twitch? I mean, I know incorporating it into your business world makes sense, but do you sit there and watch it?
You know what I like? I have watched it a few times. I like it when they will play on Twitch and then they always make a synopsis video that has the best moments. Those are great. Those are a lot of fun because you see how people are enjoying your game. You know, you never really know until you put it out there.
I know you guys spent a lot of your time and you're still spending a lot of your time with GTA 5, the updates and online content, all that stuff still coming. Is there anything in the works outside of the GTA franchise? Are we looking at another Red Dead? Are we looking at something like L.A. Noire? Anything else in the works?
I loved L.A. Noire.
I'm still playing it.
Yeah, it's so good. You know, when you create something as big as the world of GTA 5, you hope to do what we did with GTA 4 and have some interesting, you know, tell more stories in it. And with GTA Online, I'll just say that the next couple of months, there's going to be some really interesting stuff coming out.
Oh, great. Grand Theft Auto 5 out now for the PS4 and the Xbox One. Lazlow from Rockstar Games, Radio Lazlow on Twitter. Thank you so much, man. I appreciate your
time. Thank you. Love coming by. See you, E-Rock. Yeah.